Hello everybody, I'm Dr. Pratibha Pandey, Assistant Professor in the Department of Biotechnology, Noida Institute of Engineering and Technology. Today, we will be discussing eukaryotic DNA replication. In our previous lectures, we have studied about structure of DNA as well as the requirements of DNA replication, and we have studied prokaryotic DNA replication. Now, we would be studying this replication in the higher level of organism, that is your eukaryotic organisms. So, first I would like to let you to know that what is the difference between eukaryotes and prokaryotes. Like in your eukaryote, as in case of prokaryotes, you have studied that DNA is present in the circular form, whereas in eukaryotes it is present in the linear form. And one more thing which I have told you in my previous lecture, that in case of prokaryotes there is only one origin of replication, OEC, but in case of eukaryotes there are multiple sites of origin where your enzyme will come and initiate the replication process. So, the fundamental mechanism of eukaryotic replication is same as that of prokaryotic DNA replication, only with few steps are different, or you can say few different enzymes or proteins are needed in eukaryotic replication, but overall the mechanism is same in both the cases of prokaryotes as well as eukaryotes. So, first I will be discussing about the similarities between your prokaryotics and eukaryotic replication. What is the similarity? First is, dono ke case mein there is the formation of replication fork. What is replication fork? I told you earlier also that it is the your DNA strand, and once your replication will begin, it will be open up like Y form. So, this is your replication fork. So, this phenomena is common in both the organisms, that is formation of replication fork. Next is your semi-conservative replication. As I have explained in detail about this, that replication process is semi-conservative in nature. So, in both the cases, prokaryotes and eukaryotes, it is semi-conservative in nature. Then third point, which we like we have discussed in our previous lecture, what we have studied, ki jahan par ye aapka start hota hai replication, or you can say origin of replication, wahan par aapka dono side mein bidirectional mein replication fork move karti hai. So, this is common in both the cases. So, third point of similarity is movement of replication fork in bidirectional manner. Fourth kya tha? Previously also I told you that for the replication process to begin, there is a need of primer, right? So, in both the cases primer synthesis is required. So, you cannot skip this process. You need to have the primer for your initiation process of replication. And next is the Okazaki fragment synthesis. कहां पर ये ओकाजाकी फ्रेगमेंट्स बने थे? जैसा कि हमने प्रीवियस लेक्चर में देखा था, दीज ओकाजाकी फ्रेगमेंट्स आर फाउंड इन द लैगिंग स्ट्रैंड, राइट? सो दिस इज फाउंड इन बोथ द केसेस. एंड देन द नेक्स्ट सिमिलैरिटी इज, इन बोथ द केसेस प्राइमर नीड्स टू बी रिमूव्ड. एंड देन लास्ट इज द गैप ब्रिजिंग बिटवीन सिंथेसाइज्ड डीएनए मॉलिक्यूल, दैट इज जहां-जहां पर वो प्राइमर्स इनकॉर्पोरेट हुए थे, दोज प्राइमर नीड्स टू बी रिमूव्ड एंड दैट गैप हैज टू बी फिल्ड बाय द न्यूक्लियोटाइड्स. सो दीज आर द सिमिलैरिटीज बिटवीन योर प्रोकैरियोटिक एंड यूकैरियोटिक रेप्लिकेशन. नाउ यू हैव seen all the similarities. Now, there is a need to know the what are the differences between prokaryotic and eukaryotic replication. Why this overall why this overall process of eukaryotic replication is different? First of all, you should know that. So, first and the major most reason behind this is the large size of eukaryotic DNA molecule, that is around 105 to 106 kb compared to the prokaryotic DNA, that is just 15 into 10 to the power 3 kb, right, in case of E. coli. And next is packaging of this chromosome, that is more complex in case of eukaryotic DNA, that is distinct package of eukaryotic DNA in the term of chromatin. And third most difference is slower rate of fork movement in eukaryotes. In case of prokaryotes, the replication fork was opening bit more faster and they were moving in a faster rate, whereas in case of eukaryotes there is slower rate of fork movement. So, these are the major differences between eukaryotic and prokaryotic replication. Basically, it is because of the large size of the DNA molecule as well as the complex organization of the eukaryotes. Now, since there were also need of certain enzymes, but all the enzymes they are which are similar, I am not going to repeat it again, but the enzymes which are needed over here in case of eukaryotic replication, we will emphasize on those enzymes. Like first is your DNA polymerase alpha enzyme, which is needed for eukaryotic replication. Now, where it is found? First of all, you have to know the location. It is found in the nucleus, and what are its subunits? It is consisting of 4 subunits. Because of the presence of this 4 subunit, it is known as tetramer. 4 subunits hain. One is your pol A1, pol A3 and 4. One unit is your catalytic, other is your regulatory, and the last 2 units are primase. That means they would be providing primer to the DNA replication process. Its larger subunit having 5'3' polymerization activity, that means it will add up the nucleotides, and 2 smaller subunits, they are having the primase activity. Now, since I told you it is consisting of 4 subunits, so the last subunit will assist in the functioning of these larger and smaller subunit. So, overall here what it is basically doing, it is providing the nucleo, helping in the addition of nucleotides as well as in providing primer to the template strand. So, this RNA primer provides 5 to 15 nucleotides. This RNA primer are what? They are 5 to 15 nucleotides, and they are further extended by DNA polymerase alpha. And wahan par in case of prokaryotes, it was being done by DNA polymerase 1. So, only the difference is that the name of the enzymes. So, you have to more focus on the enzymes in case of eukaryotes as well as in prokaryotes. Baki the whole mechanism is same in case of both the organization, that is all the 3 steps are there. First is your initiation, second is your elongation, and third is your termination. Now, next enzyme is DNA polymerase delta. It is again located in the nucleus, and what it will do? It will do the synthesis of lagging strand. Since there are 2 strand, leading and lagging strand. So, in case of lagging strand, this DNA polymerase delta will be performing its activity. It will catalyze the synthesis. Again, it is also a tetramer having 4 subunits, pol D1, 2, 3 and 4. This pol delta, its larger subunit will have the polymerization activity, that is addition of nucleotides, and smaller have exonuclease activity, that is proofreading. That is, if there is any false incorporation of nucleotide or koi bhi galat nucleotide agar incorporate ho gaya hai, toh that will be removed by this 5' exonuclease activity of the smaller subunit of this enzyme. Is enzyme ke smaller subunit kya karega? It will perform the proofreading activity, and then high processivity when interacting with PCNA, that is proliferating cell nuclear antigen, which we will discussing in the next slide. So, next is your PCNA, that is proliferating cell nuclear antigen. About its weight, it is of 25,000 Dalton. Why it is needed? It is needed for both the process, for the DNA synthesis also as well as for the DNA repair also. It is also a multimeric protein, that means it will also have different roles. So, it is a multimeric protein and found in the nuclei. Earlier also, till now, whatever enzymes we have studied, they were all located in the nucleus. So, found in the nuclei of proliferating cells. Why we are using the term proliferating? Because DNA replication is taking place in these cells, which are growing, which are proliferating. So, what this PCNA will do? Basically, it will act as a clamp. जैसे कि आप रस्सी पे क्लैंप लगाते हो जो कि कपड़ा फैलाते वक्त दैट विल होल्ड द क्लोथ, इन द सेम मैनर दिस विल एक्ट एज अ क्लैंप जो कि विच विल हेल्प इन कीपिंग द डीएनए पॉल डेल्टा एंड डीएनए पॉल एप्सिलॉन टू रिमेन अटैच्ड विद द डीएनए स्ट्रैंड्स, सो एज कि आपकी डीएनए जितने भी एंजाइम्स है दे विल हेल्प इन द सिंथेसिस ऑफ द न्यू डॉटर स्ट्रैंड. सो इट बेसिक रोल इज दैट इट विल एक्ट एज अ क्लैंप, right? It will also hold DNA polymerase epsilon 2 DNA. Now, what this DNA pol delta will do? DNA pol delta will improve the fidelity of replication, and it is also associated with the helicase activity, that is unwinding of DNA strand. So, overall the role of this is also is involved in the synthesis of DNA or addition of nucleotides. Now, the next enzyme which is required in eukaryotic replication is DNA polymerase epsilon. Again, it is also located in the nucleus and having 4 subunits. All the enzymes which we have studied till now, they all have 4 subunits. It is also having 4 subunits. One subunit is catalytic in nature and the other 3 subunits are associated with the polymerization activity. That means, they will only involved in the addition of the nucleotides. So, one is having the 5 prime exonuclease activity. Since the words itself explain exonuclease, nuclease means it will remove, A's word is there. So, this enzyme what will do? It will remove the RNA primer from the lagging as well as the leading strand. So, 5 prime exonuclease activity, as well as it has also got 3 prime exonuclease activity, which will perform the proofreading, that is the wrong incorporation of nucleotide. It will catalyze the, since because of the presence of this 3 prime exonuclease activity, it will catalyze the repair mechanism and it will catalyze the removal of primer. Also, it will help in after removal of the primer, jo gap create hoga, that gap will be filled by this enzyme DNA pol epsilon. This will also be done. So, its role is to catalyze the repair mechanism as well as to incorporate the nucleotides in the daughter strand. Next is your replicating factor. It is also known as replicating protein, that is RPA and RFA. It is, its role is similar to the single strand binding protein which you have studied in case of prokaryotes. Jiska role kya tha? To provide, to prevent the re-annealing of the strand. So, they also do the same thing, they bind to the single strand DNA and prevent the re-annealing of parental DNA. So, these are the few differences which you need to remember in case of eukaryotes when you are writing the eukaryotic replication. Like in place of SSP, that is single stranded binding protein, in prokaryotes the same role has been done by replicating factor, that is the prevention of the re-annealing of parental DNA. Then next is the replicating factor C. You have studied replicating factor A, another is the C. C, what is the role of C? Again, its function is like a clamp loader. Clamp loader means it will assist the DNA pol delta as well as DNA pol alpha to remain attached to the daughter strand. So, what it is doing? It assists in the DNA pol delta to form clamp between your DNA and pcna. Pcna was doing the DNA synthesis activity as well as proof repair, proof reading activity. So, it will act as a clamp jo ki in dono enzymes ko jode rakhega, that is DNA pol delta aur pcna ke beech mein ek establish karega role. Now, what is this RFC? What role it will play? It will set a link between your DNA pol delta and alpha, so that ki leading or lagging strand ki synthesis simultaneously ek saath occur ho sake. They should occur simultaneously because of this RFC factor, replication factor C. Next is your, now these were the requirement of the enzymes which are needed for eukaryotic replication. Again, as you have studied in case of prokaryotic replication, there is a 3 stages, initiation, elongation, termination. Apart from that, there is one more, is their telomerase function. We will be discussing in the next slides. So, initiation, same as that case of prokaryotes, there is origin of sequences. Wahan par aap OREC ke naam se ORC, here it is known as ARS, autonomously replication sequence, or you can say replicators, which are present and recognized by your helicase enzyme which would be doing the unbinding of DNA strand. So, here as ARS. In case of prokaryotes, there was only one origin of replication, but in case of eukaryotes, there are multiple ARS. Right. This is ARS, is origin of chromosome in eukaryotes. What is this ARS? It is a core sequence which contains highly conserved 11 base pair sequences, and all are AT rich sequences, which were same in case of prokaryotes. And it is 100 to 150 long in size, right? As I discussed, they are multiple origin, not one, as in case of prokaryotes. For example, we have taken example of yeast which contains 400 ARS. Now, these multiple origins, they are spaced of about 30 to 300 kilobase pair apart, and the sequences between two origin of replication is known as your replicons. Now, next is that it is just an overview that your this ARS, autonomously replication sequence, or ARS, or the central core sequence, it contains your 11 base pair elements, which are known as ARS consensus sequence, having AT rich region. It is also known as ORE, or prokaryotes mein jise hum bolte the ORIC, yahan par kya bolte ORE, that is origin replication sequences. Now, these are flanking sequences, consist of overlapping sequences. Ab ye hai kya ORE? This is basically origin replicating element, or you can say origin recognition complex. What is this origin replicating element? Ye aapke replicating elements hai kya? These are nothing but ye jo 11 base pair sequences hai, which are rich in AT rich region. Yahan par aake aapka jab ye different protein, or you can say enzymes, kon kon se, which we have discussed earlier, that is DNA pol alpha, DNA pol delta, RFC, PCNA, RFA and helicases, jab ye sare enzymes aake us particular location par bind karenge, where 11 base pair sequences region par, which is the origin of replication, yahan par aake jab ye bind karenge, to collectively ye ek complex banayenge, which is known as the origin recognition complex. Aur yahi origin recognition complex jab tak nahi banega, eukaryotic replication initiation nahi start hoga. To yahan par difference yahi hai prokaryotes mein. Prokaryotes mein there was no need of any pre-replicative complex, but in case of eukaryotes there is a need of the formation of this pre-replicative complex. This is all about the pre-replicative complex. This is your DNA strand, this is your ARS region where your helicase will come and bind, this is ORC, origin of replication sequences. Yahan ORC will come and bind with the help of this. When this ORC will bind, to aapke other factor cell division cycle proteins which are needed for the proper replication process. To jab ye ORC bind karega aakar aapke ARS sequences pe, to they will help in the recruitment of helicase loading proteins, that is your CD6 and CDT1. Again, jab aapke ye helicase loading proteins load ho jayenge to the ARS sequence, then aapka yahan par aake DNA helicase will come, and yahan par DNA helicase ka naam hai MCM27. This will come and this will bind to this complex. Now, this complex is known as ORC complex, pre-replicative complex, which is needed for the initiation process. So, this is all about, ab DNA helicase aake bind kar gaya. Now, the next step would be, ab DNA helicase aa gaya, to aap sabko word se clear hona chahiye, it will start the unwinding process. Kiski help se karega? With the help of DNA pol delta enzyme, and it will unwind the DNA strand of parent DNA, right? It will start the unwinding, and then this DNA pol alpha, what it will do? It will initiate the primers, and now the strands are open. Again, jaisa ki aapne dekha hi tha, if there is a strand like this, ab ye khul gaya hai, to yahan par aake pehle aapka primer, or you can say yahan par as a template DNA par aapka primer aake incorporate karega. You just have to remember the name of the enzyme which is in doing this step, that is your DNA pol alpha, which is initiating the RNA primer synthesis. In case of prokaryotes, it was being done by primase. So, now after doing this, then the next DNA pol epsilon will come and it will initiate the synthesis of lagging strand. Again, SSB and this replication factor A, what will do? It will prevent the re-annealing of both the strands during the whole process of replication, kyunki re-annealing kahi bhi hui, the replication process will get stopped. And PCNA, again, it will act as a clamp, like ek support ki tarah act karega, jo ki DNA pol delta enzyme ko dissociate hone nahi dega from the leading strand. Or lagging strand mein kaun kar raha hai aapka? DNA pol epsilon kar raha hai, to wahan par aapka RFC help karega. PCNA leading strand mein help karega, RFC aapka lagging strand mein help karega dissociation ko prevent karne ke liye. This is all about the elongation process, or you can say this is the pre-replicative complex, जहाँ पर आके आपका ये MCM7 helicase enzyme bind कर गया. These are the cyclin dependent protein which were added to this. Now what will happen with the there are with the help of other auxiliary factors and this polymerase enzyme, that is epsilon and delta, they will come and bind to this complex. And what will do, what is the role of these kinases, that is CDC6, they will target the pre-replication complex and other replication proteins. So in this manner, all the DNA pol enzymes, they will polymerases, they will get associated with this complex. And once they will get associated, then inko kaam karne ke liye they need a primer. So this enzyme polymerase A or primase will come, which will in the next step you will say ye primase aayega and it will be added to the 5 prime end of the, sorry, 3 prime end of the parent DNA. वहाँ पर आके वो incorporate हो जाएगा and in this manner नए nucleotides add on होते चले जाएंगे. So and in the next step, now this sliding clamp या clamp loader will come. Why this will come? ये जितने भी enzymes आपके epsilon और ये delta सब attached हैं, ये dissociate कर सकते हैं. So for that अब आपके ये sliding clamps they will come and they will be associated with the both the daughter and the parent strand. So leading and lagging strand ये आपका आके associate कर जाएगा. Next step, once there is, अब now सारे enzymes present हैं, loader is also there which is helping them to get remain associated. Now अब नए नए nucleotides add on होते चले जाएंगे. Meanwhile there is a role of DNA pol epsilon, वो क्या करेगा, that will remove the primers, whatever primers. आप सबको पता है कि in case of leading strand there is only one primer, whereas in case of lagging strand there are need of several primers. So जब सारे DNTPs add on होते चले जाते हैं, then the last step is to remove these primers and to fill the gaps with the DNTPs, proper appropriate DNTPs, and that too इनकी sealing आपकी किसकी help से होती है, with the help of DNA ligase enzyme. So in this manner your whole elongation process will takes place. So primase enzyme that will initiate the polynucleotide synthesis, and once this, जब एक बार primer synthesize हो गया तो obviously this primase will exit, ये primase आपका exit out कर जाएगा and the nucleotides will be incorporated simultaneously to the daughter strand. Now there were two strands. The difference which we want to study is, first is we will be discussing leading strand synthesis. Here what is that? It is initiated by RNA primer. In case of leading strand, it is initiated by this and synthesized by DNA pol alpha. What this DNA pol alpha will do? Ye DNA pol alpha add karega DNA to the primer, or then this RFC will remove the DNA pol alpha and wahan par aake PCNA ko, that is a clamp as we have discussed, PCNA ko assemble kar dega in the primer strand synthesis, where DNA pol epsilon will come and wo bind karega PCNA ke saath aur perform kar dega strand ki synthesis. Kaise? With its 5 prime 3 prime polymerization activity. So overall it is nothing, sabse pehle aapka DNA pol alpha enzyme aake bind karega in the leading strand, wahan par wo DNA ko add karega to the primer and then RFC will come, जो कि इस डीएनए पॉल डेल्टा अल्फा को हटा देगा एंड देन डीएनए पॉल एप्सिलॉन विल कम. लास्टली जब सारे न्यूक्लियोटाइड्स ऐड ऑन हो जाएंगे टू द डॉटर स्ट्रैंड, देन डीएनए पॉल एप्सिलॉन के पास एक और एक्टिविटी थी, दैट इज 5 प्राइम 3 प्राइम एक्सोन्यूक्लियेज एक्टिविटी, जो कि क्या करेगी, विच विल रिमूव द प्राइमर. सो द बेसिक और मेजर पॉइंट विच यू नीड टू रिमेंबर इज द नेम ऑफ ऑल द एंजाइम्स, रिमेन द एक्टिविटी और द प्रोसेस इज सेम, यू जस्ट नीड टू रिमेंबर द नेम ऑफ दीज एंजाइम्स, विच सब यूनिट इज परफॉर्मिंग विच रोल, यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दैट. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज निक दैट इफ दैट प्राइमर इज रिमूव, जो भी प्राइमर वहां से रिमूव होगा वहां एक गैप क्रिएट हो जाएगा और निक क्रिएट हो जाएगा, दैट विल बी सील्ड विद द हेल्प ऑफ डीएनए लाइगेज एंजाइम्स. अगेन डीएनए पॉल डेल्टा विल इंप्रूव द फिडिलिटी, दैट विल इट विल चेक, इट विल परफॉर्म द प्रूफ रीडिंग एक्टिविटी. नेक्स्ट इज योर लैगिंग स्ट्रैंड सिंथेसिस, वॉट इज देयर, इट इज अगेन इट विल बी स्टार्टेड बाई द प्राइमेज सब यूनिट ऑफ योर DNA pol delta. The only difference is that, as we have discussed in case of prokaryotes also, that in case of, yeah, this is the leading strand, this is having 3 prime and primer is coming 5 prime and all the nucleotides are added to the, मैंने आपसे पहले भी बताया था nucleotides कहाँ आके add होते हैं, they will be added to the 3 prime hydroxyl group, हमेशा hydroxyl group free होना चाहिए जहाँ पर आके नया nucleotide incorporate होगा. So, in this manner, ये आपकी leading strand है, that is continuously सिर्फ एक primer से whole replication will be taking place, but in case of lagging strand, here it is 5 prime end and what is the requirement, that there is a need of free hydroxyl group. So, jitna ye portion open up hua hai, there is the 3 prime group here. So, the primer will be here only and the new nucleotides will be incorporated in this manner. But eventually, when there is the completion of this much open region, then again there is a need of another primer. So, that is why it is known as the lagging or discontinuous strand. And this region, the sequences between two primers, this region is known as Okazaki fragments. So, once the whole अब जब ये स्ट्रैंड पूरी तरीके से इस तरीके से ओपन हो जाती है और रेप्लिकेशन कंप्लीट हो जाता है, देन डीएनए दिस प्राइमर्स विल बी रिमूव्ड बाय डीएनए पॉल एफ साइलिन एंड इट विल रिमूव द योर प्राइमर्स एंड देन डीएनए पॉल डीएनए लाइगेज विल जॉइन दीज स्मॉल स्मॉल ओकाजाकी fragments. They do not have any significant role, but they were just named as Okazaki fragments. The sequence is present between the two primers. Then comes last stage is your termination. That is, as I told you, ki what is there in replication? Aapka bidirectional way mein replication fork move karta hai. Obviously, at certain point, they will come and meet. So, when they meet, at a particular time, यहाँ तक replication होके यहाँ पर एक point आएगा, when they will come and meet, it will result in the formation of two duplex DNA. Now, even though replication terminate, यहाँ पर यही major difference है in case of prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Eukaryotes के case में replication terminate तो हो जाती है, but still 5 prime end of telomeric part of newly synthesized DNA found to have shorter DNA strand, उसका DNA strand shorter होता है than that of the template parent DNA strand, उससे वो strand shorter रह जाता है. So, it will again be overcome, तो ये जो shorter region है या shortage है, this will be corrected by the activity of another enzyme, that is telomerase enzyme. और ये telomerase enzymes होता क्या है, the ends of क्रोमोसोम, यूकैरियोटिक क्रोमोसोम्स के एंड्स में एक स्पेशल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स है, दैट दे हैव अ स्पेशलाइज्ड स्ट्रक्चर नोन एज टीलोमर्स. दीज टीलोमर्स आर नथिंग बट दे आर शॉर्ट सीक्वेंसेस हैविंग अ साइज ऑफ 5 to 8 बेस पेयर्स टैंडमली रिपीटेड. एंड ये कैसे रिच सीक्वेंसेज होते हैं, जीसी रिच सीक्वेंसेज होते हैं, विच हेल्प्स इन योर मीन्स टू रिमूव दैट शॉर्टेज ऑफ स्ट्रैंड. So, you have to remember the important point about telomerase is that they are short 5 to 8 base pair and GC rich region, which are only found in case of eukaryotes. So, they form a protective cap in the ends of chromosomes. In case of eukaryotic chromosome, jahan end aata hai, jo shorter region hota hai, what they will do? They will form a protective cap, which will prevent them from degradation. And these telomeres are, why they are needed? They are needed for maintaining the chromosome maintenance and stability. And they are also responsible for maintaining chromosome integrity by protecting against DNA degradation and rearrangement. So, is tarike se wo shorter region degrade nahi hota and it will maintain the integrity of the chromosome. There is a question which I would like to ask from you all, that there is a question, excision of an RNA primer from the 5 prime end of the linear molecule would leave a gap. This gap cannot be filled by DNA polymerase action because of the absence of primer terminus. Kyunki wo shorter region hota hai, wahan par ye gap nahi fulfill ho sakta. So, if the DNA could not be replicated, the chromosome shorten ho jayega or it will lose its integrity, then ye role kaun play karega? To aapko hamesha ye answer aana chahiye, waha region jahan par primer nahi available hota, wo jo chota region, remaining region bach jata hai, that region is protected by your telomerase enzyme. So, telomerase is what? Nothing but ribonucleoprotein. Again, it contains a RNA component which will be acting as a primer. So, RNA component which have a repeat of 9 to 30 nucleotides. Now, this RNA component, right, this RNA component of telomerase will serve as a template, and where the DNA pol will come and will help in the addition of further nucleotides, and it will complete that shorter region. So, telomerase is nothing but RNA dependent DNA polymerase with your RNA component. So, telomerase, what it do? It uses the 3 prime end of parental DNA as primer and RNA component of telomerase as template. In this manner, that it adds successive telomeric repeats to the parental DNA strand, where at the 3 prime end. So, in this manner, the replication of that shorter region is also completed with the help of telomerase. So, in this way, I would like to end up with this eukaryotic DNA replication, where the major difference is the size of the eukaryotic DNA, and you need to remember the name of different enzymes which are needed for eukaryotic replication. Thank you so much for listening me so patiently. Thank you.